Hello guys, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 60.
Xiaomi's Mi 11 Ultra price in India is set at ₹69,999. Key specifications include a 6.81-inch 120Hz AMOLED display and a Snapdragon 888 processor and a 50MP triple camera. Mi 11 Ultra's sale details are yet to be announced. And Mi 11X and Mi 11X Pro price in India start from ₹29,999. The phone comes with a 6.67 inch 120Hz AMOLED display and up to 108 megapixel primary camera. Mi 11X and 11X Pro sales dates and complete specifications have been revealed. If we see Mi 11X and Mi 11X Pro comes with a 6.67 inch 120Hz Full HD Plus AMOLED display. And Mi 11X comes with a Snapdragon 870 processor, while Mi 11X Pro comes with a Snapdragon 888 processor. Mi 11X comes with a 48 megapixel triple cameras, while Mi 11X Pro comes with a 108 megapixel triple camera. And Mi 11X Pro and Mi 11X comes with a 4520 mAh battery along with a 33 watt fast charging support. And Mi 11X comes with two variants, 6GB RAM and 128GB storage is available at ₹29,999, while 8GB RAM and 128GB storage is available at ₹31,999. And Mi 11X Pro also comes in two variants, 8GB and 12GB of RAM variants, where 8GB RAM and 128GB is available at ₹39,999, while 12GB RAM and 256GB storage is available at ₹41,999. Xiaomi has launched their Mi QLED TV 75 inches has been launched in India. The Mi TV comes with an Android 10 as its OS, 4K QLED panel, Dolby Vision and Dolby Audio, and a hands-free Google Assistant support. Mi TV 75 inch QLED TV 4K is priced at ₹119,999 in India. Google Maps in India added the ability to find COVID-19 testing centers in June 2020, and now users can locate the nearest vaccination points as well. How to locate COVID-19 test centers using Google Maps? The general procedure of using Google Maps to find the nearest COVID-19 centers is similar to all platforms. User can use this data to contact testing centers in advance and given the spike in COVID-19 cases recently. First, search for COVID-19 test centers near me on your map app or a browser page. The exact search string may vary slightly too, including COVID test near me, COVID test centers and so on. The results panel will now show a list of COVID-19 testing centers in the vicinity arranged by proximity. Each result also carries the contact info of the pathological laboratories and a rating for how their services in general are. Similar to that, we can also find COVID-19 vaccination centers on map. To find the nearest one, user can search for COVID vaccine centers near me or any relevant variation of this search string. From the result page, user can find the contact details of the closest vaccination center near them. The info can come handy to understand wait times at vaccination center, clarity on documents required on search information. YouTube is finally allowing creators to change their channel name and profile picture without affecting their Google account. YouTube creators will now be able to have a channel name and a profile picture that is different from what is shown on their Google account. Until now, changing your YouTube channel name and a profile picture would reflect on your Google account as well and on Gmail. The new update will be helpful for creators who want to keep only one Google account for YouTube, Gmail, and other services. Now creators will not have to create another Google account just for YouTube because of their channel issue name. COVID-19 vaccine in India could soon be delivered by drones, as an Indian Council of Medical Research in partnership with Indian Institute of Technology is preparing to conduct a study on the feasibility of delivery of COVID-19 vaccine delivery using drones. The development comes as the center has announced about that the vaccination against COVID-19 for those above 18 years will begin across India from May 1, 2021. As part of the third phase of the inoculation drive in the country, the study was approved by the Ministry of Civil Aviation and Directorate General of Civil Aviation. Samsung launches its recycling program to bring in older smartphone models in an attempt to be environmentally friendly. However, a recent infographic shared by the company revealed that this program only managed to bring in just 0.0019% of older devices. TikTok popularized the concept of short videos, while Instagram Reels, a Facebook-flavored clone, remains a close second. It actually enjoys overwhelming success in countries like India, where TikTok has been actually banned by the government. Instagram has over 120 million monthly active users in India, and a big chunk of them are Reels users. Politics aside, it's time to get to the point that Facebook will be testing ads for Instagram Reels in Brazil, Germany, and Australia and India. OnePlus has launched their gaming triggers that is priced at ₹1,099 in India. And the gaming triggers works with multiple Android and iOS devices, and it is available to purchase from their official website. OPPO A53's 5G will be powered by MediaTek Dimensity 700 chipset. The phone could feature an LCD display with a 90Hz refresh rate. OPPO A53's 5G will be the second phone after Realme 8 5G to come with this hardware. IQ7 price in India has been revealed through Amazon promotion. It seems that IQ7 will sell for ₹34,990 in India. IQ7 specifications include a Snapdragon 870 chipset, 12GB of RAM and 120Hz AMOLED display, along with that 66W fast charging. Sony had launched the Rion Rocket wearable air conditioner through crowdfunding, and now the Japan-based company has launched a successor of the same dubbed Sony Rion Pocket 2. The newly launched product looks similar to its predecessor in the terms of design but comes with improved internals. Thanks to the improvements, the company claims that it can offer twice the level of heat absorption, resulting in more powerful cooling. EA Sports has announced that it's bringing the popular Battlefield game title to its mobile phones. The game is set to release for 2022, as we are still quite a few months away from the launch, and it will be developed by Industrial Toys in the partnership with DICE, the developer of Battlefield. First, we are really excited to have the biggest Battlefield development team ever working on our console and PC game for this holiday season. And second, we have something very exciting to talk about on mobile, and the company said it on a blog post. Asus Zenfone 8 and 8 Pro with model number Asus 104D spotted on Geekbench. The listing reveals Snapdragon 888 processor, 8GB of RAM and Android 11. Asus Zenfone 8 launch date is yet to be revealed. According to the MacBook Pro leak, schematic shows the introduction of new ports, finally improving the much criticized limited connectivity options of the laptop. These connectivity features include a full-sized HDMI port, a USB-C port and a SD card slot to the left of the laptop, while to the right are expected to have two USB-C port, a new generation MagSafe charging port standard that also appears to use USB-C port, and a 3.5mm audio port as well. Along with this, the MacBook Pro design is also slated to remove the OLED touch bar that is present in the latest laptop, although the new design still remains a Touch ID fingerprint sensor to the top right of the keyboard. At the Yoga X Ryoxin Spring product launch event, Lenovo has launched a number of accessories alongside computers in China. Let's take a look at a couple of those accessories called Lenovo Yoga CC65 Dual Port GAN Charger and Lenovo Ryoxin USB Port Lite. Lenovo has launched a couple of new devices under its Yoga series, Yoga 5G and Yoga Duet 2021. The Yoga 5G debuts as the world's first 5G personal computer with a SIM card plugged in it. And Yoga Duet 2021 is powered by 11th generation Intel Core i5 and a 16GB of RAM. These devices has been launched recently in China. China-based tech giant Huawei has quietly revealed the 4G variants of the Mate 40 Pro and Mate X2 smartphones in the home country. Both the smartphones are the same as the 5G variants, except that these new models doesn't come with the support for 5G communication.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.